Look at, here she comes. So there we are.
Good morning.
How are you, Mary?
Beautiful day.
It's lovely today, isn't it? It's much cooler and nice.
We've gotten a little bit of rain, and you know what? I think really driving up here, I think we have finally leafed out. I think we were so dry for so long, and these cool temperatures help, and hopefully we'll continue to keep getting rain.
I hope so. Yeah. So would you like to do a little adventure today?
Oh boy. We haven't thought today through that much. What are you thinking, Nancy?
I'm thinking that we should try to leave this county and go east.
Okay, where are we going east? Are we going to make them guess?
No, it's not guess, because I thought that wouldn't be fair because we're going in another county.
Oh,
you know, and
okay.
Some people like
breaking
to just,
the border.
Right, yeah. So we're going to cross the border. Right here, I have all our papers in case we get stopped for immigration, passport control.
Are your tags up to date?
Yes. How about your shots?
I've got all my shots. I've
How
got
about
my
your
shots.
Teeth?
I've got my ear tag and I've got my neckers from the vet. You know, we should be good to go.
What about your teeth? You've been to the dentist?
Yeah, teeth have been floated.
Good.
They're all cleaned up. For those of you who know what that means, that's a horse joke.
Right. That's when I take those big files. Oh, my God.
You thought drill was bad.
Really? Oh. You could be a horse and be a lot worse.
What kind of papers do we have in that bag you're grabbing for
something? In the bag, actually, besides our papers, we are getting so... Now, just stop this way. We are getting so that we might have to wear a disguise when we go into Jackson County.
Okay. I know we've got a big viewing audience over there.
Yes.
Especially because now we are also on the internet.
Yeah.
We're global.
We are all over the place.
Across the nation.
I've got a cousin in New Zealand that watches us. Here, put those on.
Here we go. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
These are really dark.
Oh.
There you go.
Oh, there we go.
And then put this hat on.
Oh, my. You are serious? Oh, my goodness. Look at how little his head must have been. Is this a child's hat?
No.
Oh.
It's for real. See, I don't think anybody will recognize this now.
Well, but I've got on my tanned shirt. You should have told me. I would have brought my lion nose.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I just thought, you know.
Poor planning on your part does not constitute
an emergency
upon mine.
I know.
For Pete's sake, but I think you're right.
Yeah.
No one will notice us creeping in the back roads of a county to the east.
That's right, and it's called Jackson. So we're going to try and... I hope everybody is up for a little adventure today.
So fasten your seatbelts.
Yes.
Because I will fasten mine as Nancy's driving.
I love this nose.
You are just a nose. Never know what you're going to come up
with.
We do really need to have like a script.
This is our disclaimer, because as you can see in the back seat, we have Zip, and she's coming with us because you never know, we might get attacked by some birds or leaves or something, you know. So she's coming with us, and this is our disclaimer because the heavy breathing, the panting, that's not me or Mary, that's Zip, okay?
Oh, goodness.
So here we go, down the road, headed east.
Here we go.
Oh, Mary, look where we're coming.
Look it. We'll see if we can get it. Not too jiggly. We don't have the crusher with us.
Jackson! There it is. We have snuck across the border. So far, nobody has stopped us.
Look at that.
We're doing good.
Zip's keeping an eye
out the back window.
Yeah, just in case she sees some
there
birds.
There she is. She's keeping an eye out. Making sure that there's no mischief going on.
Yep. No raccoons try to get into our car. So Mary, you've got something new at your place. Tell us about it.
We do. We have something called Lacey.
And what is that?
Lacey is a border collie puppy.
And it is such a cute puppy.
Oh, she's cute. She is a fat little tub who is just a ball of fuzz. But you know, I noticed the other day her legs are getting long.
Oh, yeah, it doesn't take long before they start shooting up.
Oh, they grow fast. Oh, look at. Now that's a lot of work, folks.
Oh my God, that's a lot of work.
Look at that.
Oh, but everybody tells me that oats that have been dried that way are really premium oats.
Yes, yes, because they're very clean.
Boy, that is, look, here's another field. Oh, my aching back.
That is a lot of work.
And I bet there's a lot of people watching that remember doing that.
Oh, definitely. And you know, the small grains crops this year are doing pretty good.
Here they are right here working at it.
Yep. Let's see if we can kind of get in there a little closer.
Wow.
Oh, that's a lot of work.
Oh, something must have bound up there. Yeah, it's a lot of work. At least we think it is, but you know, I think to some people it's just work, period. That's what you do, right? Yeah.
No, get her done.
Get her done, that's exactly it. But I sent some pictures of those, what do they call them? They call them stooks or shocks?
Shocks.
Yeah. All right, here we are. Now we're taking a right, and we're going to go into Taylor. We're going to go by Taylor. We won't be going through the downtown, but we are in Jackson County, and we are going to be headed southeast on our adventure today. And some of our fans, our viewers, might remember earlier this spring we did a program about Disco. And that was the little village that at one time, you know, had a lot going for it over here in Jackson County, and now it's not really there anymore. There's just a couple of houses and a park. Well, today we're going to look at another little village over here in Jackson that in its day had, you know, really had quite a few things going on. And that's Franklin.
And I'm giggling, Nancy, because we don't have the crusher with us today, and that kind of is what helps us steady the camera.
And I am going a little faster now, but when I get back onto the back roads, it'll be a lot less bounce.
I don't think we should. Okay, there's a 35. How fast is she going?
20.
Oh, 27.
Yeah, I'm slow.
We're safe.
Yeah.
We're safe. But so if there's a little extra jiggle in the camera, hey, we could blame it on Jackson County roads.
Yes, there we go.
Yes.
And we're going to go over these train tracks, so that's probably going to be a little
here, we got
bump.
A jiggle.
Bump, 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 bump. Okay.
There we go. Nancy's giving her.
Yeah, right. Oh, Nancy, pedal to the metal, you bet. So we're on County N, as in Nancy.
Yeah, that's ironic.
Yeah. And we are headed, I think, due south right now, aren't we?
Uh-huh.
So up here, this is the town of Springfield. Their town hall. It used to be a school, I believe. And we are going to be taking a left off of County N. I'm not even sure what this road is called, but we'll find out, I guess.
No, this is a different way to get to Franklin.
Well, I thought we should take the scenic route. Okay, this is East Blair Road.
There you go.
Yeah. And here we are going down here.
And now we're headed east.
We're headed east.
Okay.
Okay, headed east here. Right by the cemetery.
A very well-kept cemetery.
Yeah, Woodlawn Cemetery, and then right on the edges here is the Amish school. And it looks like they got their wood already for fall classes.
I didn't ever notice that Amish cemetery there.
Yep. Right next to the school.
Huh. Interesting.
Okay, now we're going to take a right. This is our adventure. Small adventure, anyway.
We do okay as long as our shoes are on and tied.
North Scootley Road. Now, I've heard people say Scutley, but I've heard other older people say, no, it's supposed to be Scootley.
Scootley?
Scootley. Well, look at this. They're getting ready to thresh, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
a lot of work.
It is a lot. Well, like we said, work is just work, right?
Ah, yeah, we all work.
Yeah.
Well, they're doing boards, too.
That's the thing about the Amish. They keep busy.
But they also know to take a day off.
That's right. Yep. Yep. Which is something that a lot of people...
don't do.
Don't do anymore.
I mean, really take a day off.
Right.
I think... Nancy, are we admitting a little guilt on our part?
Well, yeah. I mean, my in-laws did not usually work on Sunday. My mother-in-law, she would not do laundry on Sunday. If she did, she hung them inside so none of the neighbors could see.
Oh, because that was a scandal.
Well, it was, you know.
Something you didn't do.
Right. You're supposed to take it easy on Sunday.
Yes.
What's the old biblical thing? Unless your ox is in the ditch.
Ooh, here's some nice up-close ones, Nancy.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can get a... I'm going to hand the camera off to Nancy, and Nancy's going to shoot an up-close. That way we got to make sure that, you know, Nancy still remembers how to do this.
Yeah, I think so.
Because she's the superstar.
Oh, I am, yeah.
You are. You're a rock star.
I am. I expect every place I go in this county to have people
mob you.
Mob me.
Pull out your hair.
Oh, there she is. There she is.
That's an impressive crop.
Aren't they?
That just is beautiful.
Beautifully done. Okay, now we are going to take a right. And we're going to be headed south again on North Scootley Road. What have they got them?
Those are blueberries.
Oh.
And they're protecting them from
birds.
Birds.
Yeah. They need Zip there. She can drive those birds away.
That's right.
She's on a ball. Now, isn't this beautiful farmland over here?
It is. You know, this part of Jackson County is actually very, very fertile.
It is. There are some beautiful farms here.
Yeah.
Gorgeous. Down the road in Scootley Cooley, and we are headed toward Franklin, which is a village, and also there's the town of Franklin.
So is there a cool history behind the name?
I could not find out anything about it, but didn't seem to be anybody that by the name of Franklin living there. They probably named it after good old Ben, I'm thinking.
Oh.
Because, as they said, this is a heavily Norwegian area.
Hey, have you noticed that all the houses along this road have blue roofs?
You think they're coordinating?
I think they are. I think they are. I think that's really something wild. Isn't that crazy?
Maybe. Color coordinated.
Blue roofs, blue shutters. Huh. You notice something different every day.
That's right. I don't think I've ever noticed that. So what color of roof we got over here?
Blue.
Blue. Look at that. Look at that.
Blue roof, blue shutters. That is something funny.
Well, let's see.
That's West Jackson.
That's Jackson. Okay. We are going to go straight on to Scootley Cooley.
Doesn't this zip back around up to the ridge?
It does go up.
Yeah. To N?
Yes, it does. So I did a little research for this adventure. And actually, Jackson County and Trempealeau County came into being about the same time, around 1854.
Okay.
And there had been a lot of white people already up in Jackson County, you know, with the lumber and everything. But it didn't really officially become a county until the 1854, 1856 and this. And they said the first settler down here in the town of Franklin was a Norwegian by the name of Samson Jacobs. And he came up here in 1856 and settled. And then they said in the next couple of years, he had come from Dane County with an ox team, which I'm sure it took him a while.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and well, I suppose they must have moved dirt around during the summer, and then he just grazed them.
I'm sure, yeah. You know, oxen, that was the... They were, you know, they were slow, but they were strong.
And steady.
Yep, and if nothing else, you could eat them.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
Yeah, that was...
I shouldn't say funny, that's reality.
So they came up here, and then they said after he settled here, he must have rode back, because then they said it was a flood, a veritable flood of Norwegians.
Oh.
Yeah.
This was a hot spot.
This was it. And they just came in here. So I'm sure back in the day there were a whole lot more farms than we're seeing now.
Well, if it was a hot spot, you know.
Well, it was land that was open. And if you were coming off a farm in Norway where you were lucky if you had 3 or 4 acres, mainly of rock, to raise your family on, this must have seemed like the Garden of Eden.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So it's heaven.
It is. It is. It's a beautiful part of the world.
You had grass. You had water. They said at that time the timber was only about waist high. At least over here.
Okay.
And that too was because of the original inhabitants, the Native Americans, you know, they did a lot of burns and everything and kept a lot of the trees down.
Well, and a lot of this part of the county was prairie.
Yes.
It wasn't woods.
Just like Trempealeau County.
And the woods didn't really start happening until man started monkeying and putting in fences.
Yeah, and the burning stopped.
Right.
But then it went on to say that a lot of these people, when they first settled here, it was kind of a hard living. You know, you weren't near any big, downtown area where you could do your shopping. They were pretty much on their own. But they mainly used the oxen, and they said that the first horse teams came into this area. It was in the 1873.
Oh.
And they also said at that time the largest herd of cattle in the town of Franklin was 23 cows.
Milk cows or beef cows?
Well, it said cows. It didn't say what kind. I imagine back then they might have even been dual purpose.
Oh, right. County.
Oh, we got somebody here is thinking about throwing themselves out in front of my car.
Hey, you know what they're saying? Hey, Timmy, see if you can cross. Give you a dollar, Timmy. Jump. Or is that a Tammy or a Tina? You stay right there.
Good girl. Good decision.
Good girl. Yeah, Zip, you slept through that.
Yeah.
Zip, you missed it.
That was a good thing. Yeah, well, she's probably bored already, so.
Now, this is Franklin Road here, and this is County
N.
N.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, this is kind of where Scully Cooley Road ends, and now this road that we're going to go straight ahead on is Beck, B-E-C-K.
Okay.
Beck Road.
But keep in mind, we are taking the long way
right,
to Franklin.
Right. We are not taking the interstate.
The N.
Right. Yeah. Because Anne doesn't go through Franklin.
It comes close, though, doesn't it?
Well, you'll see. I mean, we do come out on a town, you know,
On a road?
On a, yeah, a lettered highway.
We come out on a road.
We come out on Highway C.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And look, there's a nice cornfield up here.
Isn't this beautiful? We're kind of up on the ridge.
But apparently, okay, pre-dinosaur, okay?
Okay.
Pre-dinosaur, Trempealeau County was underwater.
I've always heard people tell me that too, and that actually this was probably a deeper part of that sea, because when I was a kid, I wanted to find fossils in the worst way, and I just never did around here. And my uncle said, well, that's because that we were underwater, this was really deep.
Yes.
And that's why we don't find all kinds of little trilobites and things.
Right. But they are here in veins. But you have to find the right rock outcropping.
That's right.
Closer to the top of hills.
Oh,
because then those would have been islands and potentially have some shore.
Because my friend Sasha and I did go looking up in a quarry for fossils.
Did you find anything?
No, but she at one time had found a beautiful one up in this quarry we went to. So yeah, that what you're saying, that makes a lot of sense. And that's exactly right.
Apparently. Now, audience, please don't take off and go to the highest points in Trempealeau County with your pickaxes and start digging for fossils unless you have permission from the landowner.
I just see all these cars right now. People are putting in their picks and they're heading out.
And taking those little eyepieces that you can see the tiny, tiny little things on.
Yep. Yeah. We might there we be go. Starting a real movement here.
And there's Bliss Road.
Yeah. So I wonder how that got its name, huh?
Kind of quiet and reserved back there, isn't it?
I think so.
So what else did you find out about this little village of Franklin?
Well, it said that in 1859, and that was when they were still getting this flood of Norwegians, they started a Lutheran congregation and they built a little church. They said it was small, you know, about 20 by 30, and that was kind of closer to the county line. So that was a big advance. Then 1861, they got a school. And then in 1874, this became the town of Franklin. It got, you know, officially organized.
Okay, and, so that wasn't too long after Jackson County became Jackson County.
No, and that was a big deal. And it said the names of the first settlers here, Norwegians, of course, were Tobias and Oakland. An Ulveracker or Raker, I don't know. Johnson, Anderson, Arneson, Knutson, Tollefson. So, yes, pretty heavily Norwegian, I'd say.
This is a nice drive back.
Yeah.
This could have almost been a name that road, but we're in the wrong county.
Well, I thought so.
Yeah, we can't do that in another county.
No, we should. You know, maybe at some time we can do a Buffalo or Jackson County name that road.
For maybe the second season?
Well, if we run out of roads in Trempealeau County, we might have to, because we've done 19 name that roads now.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. So we are on the move.
And now we're headed southwest.
Isn't this a beautiful, quiet road, though?
It is.
Yeah, and here in summer, it is all canopied and just a really beautiful, beautiful road. Quiet, as you can see, not a lot of traffic. We are not dodging semis.
Oh, lots of ferns.
Yeah, beautiful, isn't
it? This is a perfect place to take a drive.
I'd say. Now we're coming down into a valley. Now they said that, and we had talked about this before, that in the winter, most of the men would go to work in the pineries.
Okay.
You know, they would go work in the lumber camps to get some cash. And it wasn't just Trempealeau County that had a lot of farms that were paid for with money earned working in the woods. It was over here as well. And the Norwegians apparently were noted for being good at working in the woods and knew how to chop trees down and do the whole thing.
They've kind of been known for that, like, for a long, long time, though,
yeah,
haven't they?
And, but of course, that meant that all the women were staying there on those farms by themselves, with their children and all the animals, and that's what they did over the winter. They were pretty much there on their own. So, you know, we got to give a shout out to those pioneer women, too. That couldn't have been real easy.
And you wonder, you know, some of these buildings look pretty old.
Yeah, there's the house back there. See it?
Yeah.
And this is kind of way up near the end of this coulee, so I imagine this was, you know, steeper land and maybe a little more narrow.
Harder pickings to make a living off of that.
Yeah. So we're going to be coming down here pretty soon. We are going to be entering the village of Franklin. And it really was quite a ways between Franklin and any other towns of any size. Oh, well, you know, let's see here. Look.
Oh, look at
rock outcropping.
Look at that. That's a pretty one. That's a pretty one.
Beautiful.
People ought to make movies about our pretty scenery. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What a good idea, Mary.
Yeah.
We ought to try that.
Sometimes the brain is not connected with the mouth.
Well, yeah.
Well, we try.
It's not just us, though. There's lots of other people that have that problem, too.
Oh, goodness. Yeah, you know, a lot of these tiny little hamlet-type communities were sprinkled all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, think of Cream, Lookout,
Russell.
Russell. I mean, even Coral City, for
sure.
That matter.
Yeah.
They're all over. If you drive through the countryside and, you know, as a child, I even remember driving through Eau Claire. And it seemed like each neighborhood had a little store. And the storekeeper and his wife lived upstairs, but they were sprinkled throughout the city of Eau Claire. You know, think of a commute. Sometimes today people go back and forth twice in a day to Eau Claire.
Yeah.
You know, and the lumber guys, they made the commute to the lumber camp and they stayed.
Well, most towns around here are about 8 miles apart. And that was pretty much, if you were traveling by ox wagon or horse, you know, going 8 miles and then turning around and coming back, that was
your day.
That was a long way. It took quite a while.
Well, and then imagine with a wagon and wheels that occasionally have problems and mud.
They weren't running on rubber tires.
And they didn't have paved roads. You know, Nancy, I find it really interesting because when we came down off that hill, the road really narrowed up almost to one lane. And now it's wide enough again for two.
Yeah, I'm sure any moment now we're going to have semis coming.
Oh.
Oh boy, white man put up big wood pile here.
Oh,
huh?
Look at this. Somebody's been working.
You bet, they are ready for winter.
Holy Hannah. And behind it is a beautiful rock outcropping. And look at all the old machinery. Look at all the old machinery.
Boy, you never know what you're going to see out here.
A couple, two, three sickle bar mowers. You can see they look like dinosaur heads.
They do.
And there's those beautiful rock outcroppings. We're going to delve into them one day. We've been talking about that all COVID, I think, haven't we?
Yeah, well, we drag that, hunt down that geologist.
And we'll get the real skinny. See, what's always intrigued me is if you look close, sometimes it's yellow sand, stone.
Orange.
Sometimes it's orange. Sometimes it's a little bit rusty looking. You know, there's all these different colors. And I wonder... What that? Oh, somebody's getting ready. Looks like he's mixing feed. That's a feed wagon. And that's a farmer and a skid steer. somebody's building something over here.
Yeah, I guess so.
Everybody works on the weekends. Remember we were just talking about that day off? Oh, that's quite a project there. Wonder what's going in the big barn. And there's a horse.
Yeah, oh, here's goats up here. Look.
Oh, I wonder if they're going to be milking goats. Are those goats or are those sheep?
I don't know.
Or is it both?
Can you tell? They're lively.
Yeah, they're having a good time.
Are they sheared sheep, maybe?
Maybe.
I like that one that's black and white. That's interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. I think those are sheep.
I think so. I think you're right. They've just, minus their,
That's a sheep.
Their wool coat, that's all.
There you go.
I think that up here now, we are coming into Franklin. And at one time, I read, they had quite a few things in Franklin. Let's see here. They had the Franklin store. That was, the people lived upstairs or in back of it.
Yep.
And the first person to have it was a guy by the name of August Yar. And then he eventually sold it to a Theodore Fossey. And their policy was it was always open.
Oh.
Yeah. And you could get whatever you couldn't get there, you could get along without it, apparently. One of those kind of stores.
Okay.
But then in the 1920s, Mr. Nelson started a confectionery in his house. I'm not sure what that means. Maybe selling candies or something.
Okay, because that's confection, right?
Yep. And then there was also, for a while, there was a sorghum mill.
And now sorghum's a crop we really don't see grown a lot anymore.
No, that provided a lot of sweetener.
They got a lot of goats. Those are goats. Wonder if they're milking them.
Could be. And they also had a feed mill here in Franklin.
Okay.
And they had a garage and auto sales.
Wow.
Yeah. And Ray Arneson had, he was an auctioneer. He did consignment sales. And there was also a filling station, and that was run by a guy by the name of Keith Hardy.
Wow.
So there was a lot going on here. The school, I said that was started in 1861, and then they improved it. They made it bigger, and their first teacher was a man by the name of Peter Moe, and he made $16 a month for teaching school.
Wow.
And after the school was closed, and I think that was, it sounded like maybe 1947, then it got turned into the town hall.
Okay.
That became the town of Franklin.
Now, is that still standing?
Well, that is an excellent question. I'm not sure what, here we are. We're in Franklin, so we can get a good gander here. Okay, we're going to take a left and just go a little ways here. If we kept going.
But now, if we just take a second.
There's the old school, or the old store, right there.
Okay, that's what we're guessing is the original old store because of the how it's built in the facade.
Yep, the fake front.
Okay. And then now, which direction are we headed?
We're going to go left, and if we kept going to the left. This car coming, I'm going to wait. Yep. We would wind up in Melrose.
And now if we look at like this little house right here, that's probably been added on to, but that's probably an original townhouse as well.
Who knows? Maybe that was the confectionery.
Yeah, could have been. You know, if you look at the style of the houses, that gives you some clues.
Now this is town of Franklin, but that doesn't.
That's look. Not an original. No. And this is these case.
That could be.
That could be an original.
Yeah, it could be.
But this isn't. This is modern.
I'd say.
Yeah, I think so.
So we're just gonna go up here and turn around. So right now, I guess we can say we're out in the burbs okay. of Franklin.
And now up here is another building. Is that the school? Like, these are modern buildings here.
This is a, this was a sawmill.
It's a furniture, furniture store.
Oh, yeah,
store.
They're making furniture. Cool.
Yeah. But if we look at this.
Oh, now that looks like a school, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Yes.
And we'll have to get a little closer for you all to see it.
Yeah, but that definitely looks like, that's got to be an old schoolhouse.
Okay.
It's gotten repurposed, remodeled, whatever you want to call it.
And I'm trying to look at, no, those are all modern day buildings. This barn, it looks original too.
I assume. All right, we'll turn around here.
Okay.
Because this is County C, as in cat.
Yep, and we got somebody riding us like a pony. That's one of the conundrums.
Oh, right.
When you're trying to take pictures of old buildings. Ooh, and then we'll, okay.
All right. So now we are officially entering Franklin.
There it is.
Yep, doesn't have a mayor, I guess, huh?
Okay.
Now, if we stayed on this road, Mary, going okay. this direction, going west, we'd come to Hague, and then Beach Corner, and then we would come out on Highway 53, and you could either go right towards Blair or left to Ettrick and Galesburg.
And that's the old school.
Yeah.
And you know, I find it very interesting because if you look closely, if we'll see if we can get zoomed in here a little bit better, the swing set equipment there is still there, Nancy.
The old-fashioned metal stuff that they don't allow these days.
No, because somebody might get their fingers pinched.
Oh, they might hit their head or something. As I said, if we would go up this road here, we would come to the Brambleberry Winery.
Cool.
Yeah, so Mary and I might have to take a...
Weddings and lodging,
yeah.
Open weekends, 1 mile. Hey, cool.
Yeah, we didn't know about this, or we would have come ready
sooner.
Yeah.
With a check.
Yeah.
With my wallet and my ID card, because, you know, I probably get carded.
Right. Yeah. Well, I can tell them you're my daughter.
Yeah, there we go. I can drink with Mom.
Yep. So now we're coming into Franklin again from the east, going west. And some other cool things I read that they actually got telephones here, telephone service in 1909. So that was really progressive.
Wow.
And they got electricity, was run out here. That was in 1947.
Well, you know, Franklin's kind of had a little bit of a rebirth.
Yeah. Look at this guy is selling.
There's a furniture store.
He's selling chairs. Look at them all.
Look at the beautiful furniture chairs. Chairs for your yard, tables. How cool is that? Those are Adirondack
chairs.
Yeah,
and they're comfortable.
I know, very comfortable. So there's furniture here, and I'm sure there's a couple of different. I bet you those people are milking goats. Milking goats. Because there's some money to be had milking goats.
Yeah, Mary, are you and Bruce gonna try?
And there's beautiful gardens. No. No. I would maybe do custom milking again, but I probably would not milk goats.
Okay.
And so, like.
Oh, look at that! It's a giant chicken.
Oh my goodness! Look at the giant chicken. Franklin.
Wow!
There is a giant chicken.
A rooster!
You know you've made it in this world if you've got a giant chicken. And they've also got like some dinosaur looking things back over here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Birds. They look like birds, Nancy. Do you remember those goofy little they were like teeter-totter birds in the 70s.
Oh, yeah.
And they had liquid in them, and they would go
perpetual.
They would go back and forth and back and forth, and it looked like he was, you know, picking corn off the ground.
Yeah.
That's what those birds look like.
All right, so now we're down here at the intersection, and there is the old store.
There's the store.
I have a real faint memory of it way back in the 70s. It was still open.
And that big house back there has the frame up with some additions on it, but that's probably an original.
Yeah.
This one back over here, the main part, is probably an original. And then, of course, there's drop-in, like this pole shed. That doesn't really fit with the, you know, 1890.
Ooh, yeah, but it fits people's needs.
Yes. So. Yes. For today.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep. So we have a real mixed neighborhood here. We've got a lot of Amish families.
Yep. Beautiful gardens.
Yeah.
Some newer homes, some older homes.
Homes that maybe were older and they fixed them up.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yep, definitely.
That could be. And it looks like over here on the left, it looks like another Amish school. Right there.
Yeah. And a greenhouse.
And a greenhouse.
So Franklin's kind of hopping back into the 21st century.
I guess so.
Oh, it looks like this guy's maybe building sheds. Yeah. Neat. Neat, neat, neat.
Now, they said that the original, that NBC stands for North Beaver Creek Church.
Okay.
The original site was down here almost on the county line, and it's marked, we'll stop there, there's a pioneer cemetery. So we'll stop there. People like us when we're out in the cemeteries, don't they? They think we're, that's where we look good running around in cemeteries.
Well, there's so much to learn in a cemetery.
Yeah, you see who was there, you know, who lived there.
And where they fit into the neighborhood.
Yep. So, I guess you could say right now that we are leaving Franklin proper, anyway. It was like a 100-year farm?
A century farm, yeah. Acres, acres.
Yeah, their name was Oakland. His Mrs. Baker was in Oakland from home. And originally it was spelled O-K-L-A-N-D. So they were one of the pioneer families over here in Franklin, the Oaklands.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Well, don't they have a sign there, that 150-year farm?
Yeah.
So what is that? Sesquicentennial?
Sesquicentennial.
150 years.
Say that 10 times fast.
Right. I can't even say it once. Slow. So that says something about people sticking around in the neighborhood.
That's right. There you go.
So right now we are headed back towards Trempealeau County, but before we cross the line again, we're going to stop at the little Pioneer Cemetery up here. And they said that was where they built the church.
Okay.
They had a church there.
The first church.
Yeah, then they moved it across the line. County line closer to Hague. So I'm sure with all these Lutherans, they had some pretty good size, you know, all these German Lutherans, Norwegian Lutherans, they probably had some pretty good sized congregations. Now if we went north, we would be going back towards Taylor. Oh, here's the Christmas tree farm, Everson's Christmas tree farm.
There you go, look at that.
And they were always so kind. They would
donate?
They would donate a Christmas tree to Fagernes at Christmas because they had relatives that were actually members of Fagernes, and they were related to these Eversons.
Hey, here's the place, come get your tree, plan ahead.
Yeah.
I bet you if you called them up, they'd let you come tag your tree, don't they? Tree farms do that.
That's a good idea if they don't.
And it's hard to believe, pretty soon, less than 6 months till Christmas.
Oh Lord. Well, here we are. And we have one sign that says that we are almost back into Trempealeau County.
By inches.
Yes. And then we're on County C, as in cat. And we're going to stop here at the little Pioneer Cemetery, which is like a beautiful little sight here.
Hey. So, it didn't say exactly where the church was, but it was here, and then they moved down the road closer to Haig. So let's take a look at some of the names here. I would imagine that they are going to be Norwegian. Simon Wenby, it looks like.
And here, 1902.
And here's Ole Lund. That's definitely Norwegian. Oh, here's Olaf Lund, but unfortunately he was only 2 years old. Oh, one of those.
This guy was young too.
And here's Olina Lund. She was 2 years old. Yeah, but here's Father Johannes Lund. So he was born in 1847 and died in 1889. So these are depressing, isn't it, when you see all these children's graves? It was a hard life back then.
So Dad died shortly after the kids.
So there might have been something epidemic going through. They had used to have epidemics of diphtheria, which was terrible. Even things that we don't hardly think about these days, like measles. You could get a real high fever from measles that killed people. There were just a lot of things around that got people back then. But diphtheria was a huge problem, and it was a real ugly disease. Wife
of a Johnson.
And Annie. Wife of L. Johnson, born 1863 and died 1898. So she was young.
Yeah,
that's
crazy.
Well, that makes you, you know, maybe appreciate a little bit. It could be children, yeah. These are the Johnsons.
You know, they can date a lot of stuff by looking at the moss.
Yeah, I've heard that. The lichens and the moss, yeah. This was Torbjör Thompson. And he lived from 1833 to 1884.
So he was an old guy. He was in his 50s.
He was old, yeah. He was old. He was ancient. Here was a Kristen Twesme. And she was born in 1847 and died in 1880.
So but that's the newer stone, though. That's a modern stone.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yep. But she was older. she was getting pretty long in the tooth, right? Isn't that something? But what a beautiful, peaceful place, isn't it?
It is.
This is lovely. I've never been by this one before.
Oh, and there's more current stuff. So this must still be... Oh, Troll Flat, Hartsfeld.
Yeah, I'm sure maybe they're still having, burials here.
I'm going to cry, Nancy, if we walk up on this and this is Donnie's. I bet you this is Donnie Hartsfeld.
Oh,
a good friend,
yes.
A good farmer,
yes.
Had the most beautiful Charley cows.
Yes.
Oh, my friend Donnie.
Yep.
You took the most awesome picture of him getting kissed by a llama out out at Werner Haas's place.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was quite the guy.
And look, he's even got the cow on his stone. That's nice, yes. Isn't it?
Yes. That's unbelievable.
Yeah, beautifully done.
And these are more current.
Here's Almond, who died in 1931, and Eleanor, who probably was his wife. She lived until 1954.
Wow, these are newer stones.
Yeah. Well, I would imagine maybe people, you know, when they buried them, they didn't have a lot of money, and when they finally got the money, then they were able to afford a newer stone.
Yep, and here's just very simple markers. And this, of course, Josephine Lovisa Torkelson.
Yeah.
And this was, it looks like March 25th to December.
Another child.
Another child.
Yeah. And it has, interesting, I've never really seen this one. It shows the open gates.
Yeah. Mm.
I can't imagine losing children like that.
Oh, my goodness. And it's at one after another. After
I know it.
The cemetery, they're full of them.
And a lot of the mothers that died in childbirth or right after childbirth, that was so common. Well, here's a Korean veteran, Marshall Graff.
That name's familiar.
Uh-huh.
And there's an Arneson and a Jacobs.
Clayton and Jacobs. Clayton Arneson and, yeah.
Casto, was that on your list?
No, I haven't heard that one. Casto, huh? No. Huh.
And, you know, I wonder if this back part, if that was early cemetery. Headstone,
but
you
they
know?
Said that they had had a church out here,
and
so
maybe this was where the church
it could have been.
But wouldn't that be odd to have the church behind the cemetery?
I don't know. At Fagernes, they're buried all around the church. They're right up close to the church,
huh.
Which kind of puts the kibosh on any building projects.
Well, you know, you could bring in a couple scientists with their fancy machines and they can do those where they send sound waves through the earth.
Well, we know that they're buried.
To find out what's underneath.
Yeah, well, we know what's underneath, and that is Norwegians.
Oh. Yeah.
Martha
Nelson?
Yes, that's what it looks like. And born 1859 and died 1900. So that was another old timer. Martha, I suppose that's Agnes. Here's Selma Matilda. In 18...
I wonder if Agnes would be married, maybe.
That could be. That I mean, like her name from home, maybe.
Yeah.
Because this looks like another child.
Oh.
Well, it looks like 1884 or something to 1891 or something.
Yeah, it feels like 91.
Yeah.
Or 90. You know, we always talk about bringing out a scratchy notebook.
Yeah, I know. And this one, we're not even sure.
No,
apparently it fell over.
The hands are shaking. They've got shaking hands.
That's here's Engel. Is that what it says? Engel?
Engel W.
And then the large name. Oh, that's I think that's another show flat, I think.
Oh, on the big name.
Or, yep. Or is it?
Yeah, T.
Yeah, okay.
TJ.
Yep.
OT. Yep.
And then this was Engelson. 4 years old, daughter of I. Olson and B.
Troflet.
Troflet. That. I suppose that was the original spelling.
Right, right. Olson with an E.
Yep.
Now, Olson with an E, that's more Swede, isn't it?
I've heard all kinds of things. I've heard that's more Norwegian. Other people say, no, that's Swedish. So I don't know. That's probably another fist fight.
And here's a roll that the markers have been lost.
Yeah. If you were living here and you were mainly getting around with ox teams and horses, you would have had to have had a tombstone brought in from a long ways away.
Well, especially when it's going to weigh.
Yeah, and especially, I'm sure it was at great expense. So, and if there had been an epidemic, say, of something like diphtheria, where a lot of people died, you know, in a relatively short amount of time, and they really had to get them in the earth. Back then, people, they didn't really understand the whole thing about, you know, germs and catching things. So I had heard that when they had the big diphtheria epidemics, that they buried people very quickly. They were afraid that even if they were, you know, passed away, that they might still catch it.
That's strange. Well, there we go.
There we go.
Another version of Cemetery Files.
Leaving you on a cheery note here. We'll mount up and we'll go down the road a little bit more. But that's pretty much it for Franklin. And again, it's one of those little villages that was filled everybody's needs there for a while. I mean, look at all the stuff they used to have there. They had stores, a garage, church, school. It was a place to be. And then as people got more mobile, and it didn't take all day to go 8 miles and back, well, things changed. It morphed. And now there's people living there, and there's somebody selling furniture, and up the road there's a winery. So, you know, things changed to meet people's needs, apparently.